With Modern Warfare's standalone free-to-play game, Warzone, Activision is pushing deeper into the Battle Royale space, and the impact for Activision could be massive. Not only that, but if it's successful, Warzone could potentially impact and influence the entire video game industry. Battle Royale has proved that it's not a fad. It started strong with PUBG, and it's only grown in size and popularity ever since. Fortnite built upon that success and elevated the genre to incredible new heights. Apex Legends, meanwhile, helped the category grow even further with its unique innovations and refined gameplay and gunplay. For its part, Activision was already in business with Battle Royale through Black Ops 4's Blackout mode, but that was just a baby step. Blackout was locked behind the paywall of having to already own Black Ops 4, but with Warzone, Activision is opening up Call of Duty for everyone. This is potentially a significant step forward for Call of Duty and the entire gaming industry. If Warzone becomes successful, it could represent a way for publishers to have their cake and eat it too. Video game industry analyst Gavin Baker points out that for a franchise like Call of Duty, Activision can essentially make lots more money by continuing to sell mainline games every year and double dipping with microtransaction revenue from Warzone. Activision's mainline Call of Duty franchise is not going anywhere. The publisher already announced that it plans to launch a new game this fall, and it's expected to be Black Ops 5. Whatever this year's new Call of Duty turns out to be, Activision will sell this game alongside the ongoing development of Warzone. This creates yet another Call of Duty revenue stream for Activision. Free-to-play games have the lowest possible barrier of entry, so they are risky in that Activision is giving it away for free, but also potentially lucrative if they spark. Free-to-play games, when done right, can generate mountains of money through their microtransactions. Just look at Fortnite and Apex. Gavin Baker, the industry analyst, said, "If Warzone becomes successful, it could become a model for other developers to follow as they look to expand their own franchises." It's not a stretch to imagine other shooter series following suit with their own standalone Battle Royale offerings. But Warzone also raises some really interesting questions about the future of Call of Duty, including what threat of cannibalization might exist. That is to say, if Warzone becomes the next bona fide Battle Royale phenomenon, could this impact the sales of 2020's Call of Duty? Activision is emphatically marketing Warzone with the tagline, "Free Call of Duty," and this raises questions about how players view the franchise. So will the expectation be, going forward, that Call of Duty is a free game like Fortnite or Apex? Beyond that, Activision has now released a new Battle Royale game or a mode for the last two Call of Duty games. So should fans expect this year's Call of Duty and those beyond it to also include Battle Royale modes? There are no clear answers to these questions yet, and that makes sense. Activision is clearly experimenting with Warzone, both in terms of its creative design and the business strategy behind it. As such, it's too early to say what the impact will be long-term for Activision and the wider industry. What is clear is that Activision is finally delivering on what fans have been asking for, a multiplayer-only Call of Duty release, and that's a really big deal.